Hi, I'm Jon Schwabish, and today I'm going to teach you how to create a custom color palette in Excel. Now to do so, we're just going to modify simply by clicking and pointing and dragging. We're going to modify the existing underlying default Microsoft Excel color palette. When we're done with that, Excel is going to generate for us what's called a .xml file. And we're going to be able to take that file and be able to share it with others on our team or in our organization so that when they open their version of Excel or PowerPoint or Microsoft Word, they'll have those same default colors available to them. So this is a great way to make better looking, more consistent, and more styled data visualizations in your work simply by taking just a few minutes to create this custom color palette. So take a look at this video and you'll see how easy it is to create a custom color palette in Excel. Let's create a custom color palette in Excel. I have some fairly simple data here, births per year in these 4 years by region of the world, Africa, Asia, Europe, Latin America, North America, and Oceania. I've created a fairly simple stacked bar chart here, and I've got my color palette pulled from the Eurostat style guide. And you can see I've got the 9 theme colors, the CMYK color model, RGB, and hexadecimal over here. Now, what I can do if I want to use these colors in this graph is I can simply just grab a series. I could go over to the Home tab, grab, say, the color menu, change the fill. And let's say I want to make this this blue series. Let's say I want to make it this red color here. So I'm going to literally just type in the color code. So B93C46, click OK. And I've got that red color there. And if I want to customize each one of these, it's kind of a pain because I've got to do that manually. And then when I have an entirely new file with different graphs, these colors aren't going to be there. So I'm going to have to redo that whole process. So instead, what I'm going to do is create a custom color palette that I can use and reuse. So if you're on a PC and a Mac, there are two different methods to doing this for each of those operating systems. If you're on a PC, you can work in Excel directly. And you can go to the Page Layout tab, and on the far left is the Colors drop-down menu, and you can see there are a whole bunch of other color palettes built in. You can see as I scroll down here, the chart behind it is changing color. So this is where we're going to add our custom color palette down here. You can see there's a Customize Color button down here at the bottom. Let's come back to that in a second. If you're on a Mac, you need to do this process over in PowerPoint. You're going to go to the Design tab. On the far right under Variants, you're going to go to Colors, and at the bottom, same menu here, and at the bottom, same as Customize Colors. I don't know why Microsoft does this differently in PCs and Macs, but there you go. So you'll end up in the same spot. You'll just do this in PowerPoint rather than Excel. But I'm going to use Excel today, so I'm going to go over back to Excel, Page Layout tab, Colors, and at the bottom, I'm going to hit Customize Colors. And you can see here that I have this menu that gives me 10 different colors. There are two pairs of text and background. So you can see dark one, light one, dark two, light two. It's mocked up over here on the right. So you can see what it's going to look like. There's a hyperlink and a followed hyperlink color at the bottom. I never change these. Blue and purple is sort of our standard. And then there are 6 accent colors. And these are the colors that are going to be used in our charts. And the order matters here. So if I have one color in my chart, it's going to be this blue color. If I add a second series, it's going to be this orange. So if I want to have all of my charts from Eurostat, if I have one line or one bar in that chart and I want those to be blue, I want that to be in the accent one position. So let's change these colors. So I'm going to use a drop-down menu here. I'm going to go to more colors and I'm going to actually type in this hex code. So 466EB4. And so you can see doing this one after the other is a little bit of a pain. Takes a little bit of time. I'm going to do one more here. I'll do the drop down and I'll type in for this purple color right here, AF4B91, and hit OK. And so you can see that this is changing here in the drop down and in the little mockup. I've, of course, already sort of done this a little bit down here, so you don't have to watch me go over and over and over again. So I'm just going to click these at the bottom and I'll grab this red color as this last one. And so you can see here are my Eurostat colors already mocked up. Let's name this color palette Eurostat and click save. And if I go to page layout colors and hit the drop down menu, there is the Eurostat color palette. I want to go back to office, just select that one. I want to use Eurostat. I can go there. Let's go over to PowerPoint, click the variance menu, colors, and there it is right here in PowerPoint. So if you are on a Mac, you're doing this in PowerPoint, it will load in your PC. If you're on a Mac or if you're on a PC, you can obviously do this in either tool, PowerPoint or Excel, but the custom palette is going to show up in all of your tools automatically. So you can see how that's worked. So let's just create another little chart here. Let's create a, doesn't make sense, but we'll create a little pie chart here. It doesn't really make sense, but you can see that my palette, my colors are already being set up directly in this chart because I have made those colors. Let's insert a line chart here just to demonstrate, and you can see that my colors are all set. They are using that Eurostat color palette. Now, what's great about this color palette and creating it is that I can actually share it with people. Now, to find the color palette isn't so easy. I've already gone navigated to this window. And I'll put the link to this video below so that you can go get it yourself. The only thing you need to change is what your username is. The challenge with just finding this little path is that the app data folder is usually hidden on Windows. So if you can unhide that, then you can navigate to see users, your username, app data, roaming, Microsoft templates, document themes, and themes color. And you will get the Eurostat.xml. This is just an XML file, which you can then share with people. And as long as they put it in their same folder, in this document themes, themes color folder, it will show up in their version of Excel and you'll be all set to go. So that's how you create a custom color palette in Excel, PowerPoint, and all the Microsoft Office tools, simply by using that page layout tab, colors, and then inputting your color palette.